Recorded Books Incorporated presents an unabridged recording of Pinky and Rex by James Howe, narrated by Christina Moore.
Chapter 1. Pinky and Rex Get Dressed.
Wake up, Pinky!
Pinky's eyes popped open. His little sister, Amanda, was jumping up and down on his bed.
Wake up! Wake up! She cried.
I am awake, said Pinky. Stop jumping on my bed.
We're going to the museum,
Amanda shouted. She did not stop jumping.
We're going to see the dinosaurs. Hurry up, Pinky. Get dressed.
Pinky got out of bed and ran to the window.
Rex, he called out.
Rex,
he called again.
Hi, Pinky.
Rex called back from a window in the house across the street.
I can't decide what to wear to the museum today. Should I wear my Tyrannosaurus t-shirt or my Stegosaurus sweatshirt?
Wear your Tyrannosaurus t-shirt, Pinky shouted. It's too hot for a sweatshirt.
What do you think I should wear? My shirt with pink and white stripes or my shirt with pink and blue checks?
I like the shirt with pink and blue checks, said Rex. It's my favorite.
Mine too, Pinky said.
He had never thought that the shirt with pink and blue checks was his favorite, but now that he knew it was Rex's favorite, it was his too.
See you later, Pinky shouted.
See you later, shouted Rex.
What should I wear to the museum today? Amanda asked her brother.
Who cares? Said Pinky.
And he went to brush his teeth. Chapter 2. Too Many Animals. When he came back, Amanda was counting his stuffed animals.
You have too many of these things, she said. You should give me some.
You say that every morning, said Pinky. Besides, they're not things, they're my animals.
But you should, Amanda insisted. I have only 13 animals, and you have 27.
When did you learn to count that high? Pinky asked, because he knew that she was right.
He did have 27 animals. And every morning, after he had gotten dressed, and after Amanda had told him he had too many animals, he said goodbye to them, each and every one. He said goodbye to his frog. He said goodbye to his bear. He said goodbye to his kangaroo. He said goodbye to his elephant, his giraffe, his three cats, his four dogs, his five rabbits, his alligator, his lion, and his tiger. He said goodbye to his monkey. He said goodbye to his mouse, and his moose, and his mole. Some animals he hugged because they were little and needed to be hugged. Some he patted because they didn't care to be hugged first thing in the morning. And some, like his spider and his porcupine, he didn't touch at all because they didn't care to be hugged, ever. He always saved his pig for last. Pretzel, named for his curly tail, was special. He had been given to Pinky when he was a baby, and Pinky loved him best. In her room, in the house across the street, Rex said goodbye to her friends, too. She had some bears and cats and even a pig, but she didn't love them best. Her special friends were her dinosaurs. She knew all their names and how to spell them, even the pterodactyl. In fact, Rex knew just about everything you might think there is to know about dinosaurs. And she loved them all, each and every one. After she had eaten her breakfast, Rex ran outside and across the street.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.